What did you think of the court's decision?
Well, I can't say I was surprised, Michael. You know, it was one of those things where Elliott had a chance because the courts don't necessarily reverse the lower court judge that often there in the Fifth Circuit, that particular judge. But it was always a bit of a long shot for Ezekiel Elliott, because here's what the court decided. They basically said that the NFLPA filed this thing too soon. They filed this case in Texas before Harold Henderson made his ruling on Ezekiel Elliott's appeal. Their reasoning was, well, he already ruled against us on the particular evidentiary things we need, so we knew we weren't going to get the decision we needed, so we went ahead and filed. But the way the courts work, they need that process completed. You have to exhaust your remedies under the collective bargaining agreement before you can come into the court. So that's what this court decided, and they basically now send it back to the district court and say, you have instructions to dismiss the case.
Okay, Ryan, a source tells Adam Schefter, whom we'll hear from in a minute, that Elliott's lawyers have the option of still refiling in Dallas or fighting the suspension in New York, a decision they are discussing now. How would you advise his attorneys?
Yeah, they have a couple things going. They can do either. I think you now have to switch the battleground to New York and do the same thing, essentially, that they did in Texas. You go and you say, I want a preliminary injunction, temporary restraining order. I want to keep Ezekiel Elliott on the field, same issues, and see where you get with it. They also have a chance, when you look at it, they could possibly ask the entire Fifth Circuit to rehear this case. That's unlikely that they'll get that. But I think at this point, you got to shift the battleground to New York, and you got to try to fight the fight there and do whatever you can to keep him on the field.
So, Adam, what's next in the Elliott case?
Well, Michael, as a practical matter, Zeke Elliott's suspension begins right now. But the Cowboys, as you mentioned, are on a bye week. So the fact that they're on the bye week affords his legal team time to now mull through the options to decide what they want to do next. And New York seems to be the most likely scenario, that they would refile this case in the Southern District Court in New York to see if they could get the suspension lifted again so that Zeke Elliott could play. The legal team is going over those options as we speak, and next week there is expected to be, as it was described to me, a flurry of legal activity. So clearly he is not ready to give up the fight. He continues to want to see if he could get this six-game suspension put away, turned away for the time being, and we will see what he decides to come up with. But interesting timing in that the Cowboys had the bye right now, because if they had a game this weekend, the suspension could kick in right away.
Now, is this the development, Adam, that you expected? Were you surprised at all by this? And what's been the reaction from your sources around the league to this decision?
I think, look, everybody right now is waiting to see what Ezekiel Elliott does next. I think a lot of people thought that he would get to play this season. I think that comes as something of a surprise, maybe, that the court decided what it did. But I could tell you this, the people in Philadelphia, in Washington, they're very pleased by this decision. People in Dallas, not so much. The league office, also very pleased. The people in Dallas are the only ones right now that don't like this. But the Cowboys also are 2-3. The season has not gone the way they want. The vibe in the locker room right now over Jerry Jones' comments is not good. Mm-hmm. This team is dealing through a lot of issues right now, Michael. Ezekiel Elliott is the latest amongst them, and we'll see what he decides to do next week.